everyone. Let me introduce myself. Okay, my name is Siti Nozawani binti Muhammad Zakri. Okay, so my topic is about it. So to be related with my topic, I would like to share with everyone about a few top local Kelantanese dishes. Because actually I am from Kelantan. So I know of course everyone feel excited to know what the top local Kelantanese dishes. Okay, firstly the top local Kelantanese dishes is nasi kerabu, and I know everyone haven't tried nasi kerabu. Okay, actually nasi kerabu is Malay rice dish, and sometimes we also known nasi kerabu has a nasi ulam. For the nasi kerabu, sometimes the people most prefer two type of rice, which is the rice blue color and also the yellow color. For me, I mostly prefer yellow color, and also for my mom too, because sometimes when my mom make nasi kerabu, she mostly prefer yellow color. Actually, I don't know why, but I think yellow color is a nice color with a brightness. And when we do nasi kerabu with yellow rice, it can look, it can make nasi kerabu more delicious. Okay, nasi kerabu, we can eat with fried chicken, fried rice, or sometimes with grilled meat. For the nasi kerabu also, we can eat as a breakfast, lunch or dinner. Anytime we can eat nasi kerabu. So if sometime we you guys want to make a event like family days, I think the best menu is nasi kerabu, because it can make people feel full and satisfied with that food. And after that, has a conclusion. Nasi kerabu is suitable to make as a main menu in any event, any program or any ceremony that you want to do. Roti titap is also the top local Kelantanese dishes. At Kelantan, the most popular place that serve roti titap is Kopitiam Kita. This is Kota Baru's iconic breakfast set that does not contain a single grain of rice. Kopitiam Kita's signature roti titap is a perfect marriage between sweet and silky. Roti titap is made by bake a piece of toast and rising with kaya, which is coconut and panda jam, and then mix well with half boiled egg on top of thick toast. It's so delicious. So let me show you a few pictures of Kopitiam Kita and roti titap. Thank you. Okay, another top local Cantonese dishes is nasi dagang. Nasi dagang is also the most popular food that everyone should try, that everyone should eat when they come to the Kelantan. Nasi dagang also can prepare as a breakfast, lunch or dinner. But mostly the people eat nasi dagang as a breakfast only. Another that, we can make nasi dagang as a main menu in our happy day. For example, Hari Raya Puasa or another event. Okay. For me, every year when we celebrated Hari Raya Puasa, my mom always make nasi dagang as a main menu because all my family from another country we come back to the village to celebrate Hari Raya together. So after everyone finish doing solat sunat Aidilfitri, we come back to the home and we eat nasi dagang together. So this situation is show our happiness and also can make our family closely. Usually nasi dagang will be eaten with chicken or fish curry. So it's so delicious. So let me show a few pictures of nasi dagang. Traditional food that popular in Kelantan. Okay, for example is kuih akok, kuih cemek, kuih lompat tikam, kuih buah peria and kuih bunga tanjung. This all is most popular in Kelantan. There are many another traditional food, but that's only I want to describe it. If you guys want to know another traditional food, you guys can Google or just come to my country, which is Kelantan. Usually, when Ramadan was coming, there are a lot of dishes and a lot of traditional food that are sold at the Bazaar Ramadan. Every year, there are many people were going to the Bazaar Ramadan, include me. I love to go to the Bazaar Ramadan because there are a lot of dishes and traditional food that we have not seen before. For example, is kuih bunga tanjung because people does not eat kuih bunga tanjung every day except on the Ramadan. So it's like a unique traditional food because we does not have seen every day. Not seen with kuih lompat tikam, kuih buah peria and so on. Besides that, at the Bazaar Ramadan also have a
any type of meat, for example, ayam percik, ayam masak merah, ayam bakar, ayam madu bakar, and also fried chicken. So, when we go to the Bazaar Ramadan, we can choose any things that we want to eat for iftar. And after that, for me, for the traditional food, I most prefer kuih akok and also kuih cik mek, because both of traditional food are my favorite. Okay, last, I will show you guys a few pictures of traditional food and also a few pictures of me. There is a few top local Kelantanese dishes. So guys, for those is like food hunting, I prefer you guys to come to the Kelantan and try the food. I'm sure and guarantee you guys will be not regret. So that's all from me. Bye bye.